Praise the Lord. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Eucharistic celebration. We pray for divine retreat, Saint Summersby. Heavenly Father, let your eyes be open night and day upon the divine retreat, Saint Summersby. May your holy presence fill this house of prayer. In this, your temple, may the rejected feel accepted, the depressed find hope, the wounded find healing. Protect your home from all afflictions, and let your Holy Spirit rest upon it. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. The entrance antiphon. All the earth shall bow down before you, O God, and shall sing to you, shall sing to your name, O Most High.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with
you. Dear loving children of God, today, let's remember everyone who is struggling with fear, different kinds and types of fear that disturbs and spoil and steal the joy of their ordinary day and ordinary life. We remember such people who are really struggling with this fear, excess or uncontrollable form of these passions in life. Brethren, let us acknowledge our failures and shortcomings. So prepare ourselves to celebrate this sacred mystery in a worthy manner. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fall. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, who govern all things both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Be seated for readings.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. You remember that Melchizedek, king of Salem, a priest of God Most High, went to meet Abraham, who was on his way back after defeating the kings, and blessed him, and also that it was to him that Abraham gave a tenth of all that he had. By the interpretation of his name, he is first King of Righteousness and also King of Salem, that is, King of Peace. He has no father, mother, or ancestry, and his life has no beginning or ending. He is like the Son of God. He remains a priest forever. This becomes even more clearly evident when there appears a second Melchizedek, who is a priest not by virtue of a law about physical descent, but by the power of our indestructible life. For it was about him that the prophecy was made, "You are a priest of the order of Melchizedek and forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
The Lord's revelation to my master, "Sit on my right, I will put your foes beneath your feet."
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
The Lord will send from Zion your scepter of power. Rule in the midst of all your foes.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
A prince from the day of your birth on the holy mountains, from the womb before the daybreak, I begot you. The Lord has sworn an oath he will not change. You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
Alleluia, alleluia. Jesus preached the good news of the kingdom and healed all who were sick. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went into synagogue, and there was a man there who had withered hand. And they were watching him to see if he could cure him on the Sabbath day, hoping for something to use against him. He said to the man with the withered hand, "Stand up out in the field." Then he said to them, Is it against the law on the Sabbath day to do good or to do evil, to save life or to kill?" But they said nothing. Then, grieved to find them so obstinate, he looked angrily round at them and said to the man, "Stretch out your hand." He stretched it out, and his hand was better. The Pharisees went out and at once began to plot with the Herodians against him, discussing how to destroy Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord. Brothers and sisters, all these days we were listening. The Pharisees and the Sadducees, their nature towards Jesus and the disciples. Last 2 days' gospel, the first day they were questioning why John's disciples were fasting and the others were fasting, why your disciples are not fasting. And yesterday again, why your disciples are picking up the head grain and eating when they walk in the cornfields. And today, directly their attack and their question towards Jesus. Brothers and sisters, one thing that we know about this passage, we reflected this it many times, but one thing which we need to learn from this passage, the mentality and attitude of Pharisees and Sadducees, they're obstinate, means they have already planned things. When you come for a discussion or a dialogue, if you come with already planned something, then whatever you speak or whatever you say, that will point to one thing that you're already thought in your heart or in your mind. So arguments or debates is not like discussions. Arguments and debates both are in the same pattern, where you come with an hidden agenda in your plan, And whatever you hear from the opposite side, still you go with your sharing and what you thought in your heart and mind. Exactly the same way, Jesus performed something so good on the Sabbath day, helping a person and giving that peace at his distress, or when he was really struggling with his physical pain on his body, Jesus healed him completely, and people could not reflect the good aspect of it. Instead, they want to pinpoint about this. So this will happen often in the present world. If a person is bad for you, whatever she or he is doing, we will try to pick something evil from that act. We won't see what is good of it or good out of it, the goodness that the person received, but try to bring out what's evil, because basically we don't love or like that person. Sin, whatever the sin that we commit, that breaks relationship with God for sure, no doubt about it. But Jesus teaches something more. More than sin, what is that more than sin? Hardness of our heart. When I commit sin, I say, Lord, I'm a sinner. There will be a kind of sincerity in my heart. Lord, I made a mistake. I'm sorry. But there are people, just like the Pharisees and Sadducees' attitude, go with that hardness of the heart, never accepting the truth, which is more dangerous than sin. Because as Jesus said, they are so obstinate, means so stubborn, never open to the truth, never come to know the truth, because they are so obstinate and so stubborn, they want to go with that hard-heartedness. Brothers and sisters, whatever the Holy Spirit inspires us to take away from today's gospel, let us take it and try to do well in our personal life. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. With a humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and by me. Wash me, and O Lord, from my iniquity, cleanse me from all my sins. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith. And His coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim, Holy, 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 Holy Lord, God of hosts.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna
in the highest.
Blessed
is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection,
you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we might be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Anthony our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. Have mercy on everyone who is struggling with excess form of fear in life. We pray with Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her devoted spouse, Blessed Apostles, and all the saints, Saint Vincent de Paul, Saint Mary Immaculate, and all those who have pleased you throughout the ages, they might merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we might be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy
that you should under my roof, but only say a word, my soul shall be healed. Those who are not able to go to church today physically, this is your time of spiritual communion. You can join along with me when I do this prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things. I desire to receive you into my soul. Come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as you are already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. May the body and the blood of Christ keep us to have eternal life.
Amen. Communion antiphon. You have prepared a table before me, and how precious is the chalice that quenches my thirst.
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
May
the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Glorify God by our lives. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits, wander through the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Prayer for priests. O Jesus, keep all your priests
within the shelter of your sacred heart, where none may harm them. Keep unstained the laid on their hands, which daily touch your sacred body. Keep unsullied their lips, purple with your precious blood. Keep pure and unearthly their hearts, sealed with the sublime mark of your glorious priesthood. Let your holy love surround them and shield them from the world's contagion. Bless their labors with abundant fruits. And may the souls to whom they have ministered to be their joy and consolation, and in heaven their beautiful and everlasting crown. O Mary, Queen of the Clergy, pray for us and obtain for us many holy priests. Amen.
Peaceful dove, teach us wisdom.